I think, you know, the HPA axis, I think we need to break it up into various buckets. I think there is the psychological component, which is asking about experiential stress exposures, just taking a basic history about what's going on in a person's life and why they are experiencing stress, whether it's because of a divorce or a loss of a job or an illness particularly. The second is understand the genetics of stress. That includes specific pathways that regulate or dysregulate the HPA axis. Those include MER-181, which we talked about as being one of the primary genetic factors that controls the inflammatory response to stress, but also other genes like FKBP5 and the serotonin transporter. We also need to understand the downstream proteomic effects of stress, which increased inflammation, activation of phospholipase A2, imbalances of omega-3, omega-6 fatty acids, elevation of arachidonic acid, IL-6, and pro-inflammatory cytokines. Then we need to understand essentially how those show up clinically, whether it's through hypertension or irregular blood sugar or dyslipidemia. And then putting all those things together in terms of making a rational interventional platform approach to a patient that addresses all five of those pathways, the psychological, the genetic, epigenetic, the physiological, as well as the symptomatic. So I think, you know, if you speak to classic endocrinologists, they really sort of wince at this concept of adrenal fatigue. I think that we need to, you know, look at these as binary systems at one level, but also look at the granularity between them. So at one extreme, we have hypercortisolemia. That's associated with fight or flight, insomnia, agitation, restlessness, hypervigilance. The other extreme are patients that have had, you know, basically burnout, where they are not able to respond properly, either immunologically or endocrine ways, to stress. And most people are somewhere in the middle of that. So we need to kind of understand sort of not only the biology, but the phenomenology of stress. We can't divide it up into, oh, you have excess adrenal activity and you have adrenal burnout, and let's just try a one-size-fits-all. I think it's much more about modulating as opposed to either increasing or decreasing adrenal function.